No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
I do not owe any of you my time or these words. I am not here to be your token. I am here because my classmates requested it. And that is the painfully beautiful part in this moment for me. I was really scared of coming up here and giving this speech. I bet Brianna Taylor was scared to pull out a customized version of an alarm clock, the piercing sounds of the 8 bullets that struck her, killing her in her bed. Leon Arbery had to be terrified when his run was cut short, not because he had to stop and take a breath, but because a father and son took it upon themselves to make sure that he would not be able to take another. I know George Floyd was filled with terror. Close your eyes for me. Picture yourself on the ground, your face buried in cement, and the weight of an officer's knee placed on your neck, not for 3 or 5, but 8 minutes and 46 seconds. I don't know what's heavier, the power that badge holds or the decades of racism, oppression, and hate. Please, I can't breathe. I can't breathe. My stomach hurts. My neck hurts. Everything hurts. They're gonna kill me. Dead. No justice!
No peace!
Right now, we're here with our friends and family. We all know what it's like to love someone. And unfortunately, most of us know what it's like to lose someone. But very few of us know what it's like to be a part of a cycle where you constantly lose loved ones due to a physical characteristic. I wanted this moment to be one filled with genuine laughter and sincere smiles, but my heart hurts. It's too heavy. Racism is not getting worse. It's getting filmed. There are many teens that would have graduated today if they were in the wrong place at the wrong time in the wrong skin. Their skin. My skin. I read this quote that said, "Shaming someone into action creates acting. Inspiring someone into action creates change." This is something I needed to hear and I am still struggling with. This is for my black people. It is not your job to inspire white people to care about you. Listen to me when I say it is not your duty to break down to a white person why your life matters, even though here I am doing so. I'm coming to you as a black woman who has been fighting for too long. Fighting for my existence, fighting so that me and everyone who looks like me can jog, play with toy guns, and buy skills without dying. I'm tired of the bloodshed. The pain that these families are in, they don't want to see their child smothered across social media as hashtags. They were someone's kid, sister, brother. They had goals and dreams. They wanted a chance to grow up. A chance to start a family of their own, and for what? So that they too can fear burying their child? I am beyond terrified right now, but I refuse to be silent because I will not be burying my kids. Yes, it is a minority group being targeted, but the majority needs to be outraged. Silence is not an option anymore. For those who think it's political, for those who are disgusted by the scared 17-year-old making history here, understand your privilege. You have spent many years debating whether or not the life of someone else matters. This right here, this is a human rights issue. It's not black against white, it is us against racism. I can stand on this stage and say all this to you. I can get on 100 more stages and say it again. But it won't count until every single one of you can passionately revoice this same message. Please, class of 2020, all I ask is that you make it count. Change starts with you.